Welcome back to my stand-up channel. The son of Helena Hutchins, who was fatally shot on a film set, fell silent on hearing of the tragedy, her father revealed yesterday. Anatoly Androsovich said 9-year-old Andros was unable to utter a word after being told star Alec Baldwin had accidentally shot dead his mom with a prop gun. Anatoly, 66, told The Sun. Andros was incredibly close to his mother and fell silent when told she was dead. Matt was really worried because the boy withdrew into himself and couldn't say a word for 2 days. His dad has managed to coax a few words from him now, but the effect has been devastating. This tragedy has wrecked a beautiful, perfect family. Everyone who knows them is destroyed by sorrow. It comes after Thursday's tragic accident on the set of the Western movie Rust, which killed Helena, 42, and saw director Joel Souza hit in the shoulder. The shattered star was snapped with Helena's grieving husband Matthew, 38, and Andros, at his hotel in Santa Fe on Saturday. The Oscar-nominated actor and Matt shared a tight embrace before Baldwin hugged Helena's young son. Matt had originally traveled to Albuquerque where his wife's body was brought before traveling to Santa Fe with Andros, it's reported. Father and son stayed at the same hotel for at least a night before leaving on Saturday afternoon with their luggage. An eyewitness said of Baldwin's appearance. His body language was of a beaten man, he was slumped, he looked aged. I thought at first he grabbed the luggage cart to help him walk because he looked so down. The night before, all three had attended an intimate, private memorial for Helena with other members of the crew amid claims of walkouts and problems on set before the shooting. Anatoly, a retired Soviet nuclear submarine captain from Ukraine, showed off a snap of Helena and Matt's wedding day yesterday as he struggled to contain his grief. He recalled the happy day in June 2005 when he proudly walked Helena down the aisle at her traditional wedding in Ukraine in his naval dress uniform. He presented groom Matt with a traditional Ukrainian loaf of caraway bread symbolizing prosperity while his wife Olga, now 63, carried a bouquet at the ceremony. Devastated, Harvard Law graduate Matt lived in Ukraine where he learned the language and became close to his in-laws before taking his talented bride to America to further her movie career. Anatoly said, "Matt couldn't reach me at first to break the news to me because I'd lost my phone but eventually got through to Olga and Helena's sister Svetlana. He told them about the tragedy and said he loved Helena so much, he was devastated. He managed to get through to me on Saturday night and sounded very upset. But his biggest concern was for Andros who had stopped talking completely. It's terrible because we were so proud of them and loved seeing how happy they were, and now it's all gone. We want to do everything we can to support Matt because we are very close to him after getting to know him while he lived in Kiev while Helena waited for her papers to fly to the US. I'm hoping my wife and daughter will be able to go there to comfort Matt and Andros soon." Weapon mix-up? A probe last night continued to focus on the role played by rookie armorer Hannah Gutierrez-Reed, 24, who is feared to have mixed up weapons laid out for scenes. Sources claimed the vintage-style Colt 45 pistol which killed Helena was loaded with real bullets and used by crew members for target practice when cameras weren't rolling. It was also claimed the gun may even have been taken off set as recently as the day before Thursday's horror. Mission Impossible star Baldwin is understood to have been handed the Colt revolver believing it was a cold gun, loaded with blanks, when it was a hot gun, containing live ammunition. Helena's sister Svetlana, who lives in Indonesia, revealed the horror completed a triple tragedy for Matt. She said, "What Matt's living through is beyond comprehension. Visa denied, his mother passed away a while ago and this year he lost his dad to COVID, and now his wife. The mother for their son, the daughter for our parents. And my sister." Svetlana also poured out her anger last night, revealing her mother had been granted a US visa to launch a mercy dash to grieving Matt and Andros, but she was refused. The younger sister said, "My mother's request for a visa has been granted but mine has been rejected. I'm sure it's because I am young, beautiful and single and they think I will try and stay there. My father can't go with us, he is in pieces and almost had a heart attack when he heard the news, so it is better for him to stay here in the Ukraine. Andras is such a smart and beautiful child. Helena adored him and he will be missing her so much, we need to be with him to support him. Whatever we do, whatever action we take, nothing can bring her back. The best thing we can do now is to stick together as a family and support each other. Source: nypost.com. Please like, share and subscribe. Thank you for watching.